हेलो एवरीवन, यू आर ऑल वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 903 एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज इन कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ द पेंट्स बाय मिक्सिंग ऑफ डिफरेंट इंग्रेडिएंट्स इंक्लूडिंग पिगमेंट्स। सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ industrial structure where four floors we discuss. On top floor, that is fourth floor, we are mixing, that is all the ingredients are put, they are known as batch material. On third and second floor, mixing and grinding, and then addition of thinner, quality check, and finally on ground floor, packaging. So that was the outline of that industry. Here I have given the chart diagram how these ingredients are mixed, and that is the full movement of the different ingredients in the different compartment. So here in this diagram, that is known as industrial manufacture of paint, flow chart of mixing of paint. So this is the flow chart, how the paint is mixed in the manufacture of paint. So here these four containers are there, these compartments. One is on top, that is it contains tin and thinner. Then the second one, which contains resins. Third one, which contains oils, it may be linseed oil or anyone which is required. And here the last one is pigments. So these are the chemical constituents, ingredients which are ready to mix in different compartments of containers: pigments, oils, resins, tint and thinner. Here there is a big feed tank, so they are all supplied. This our whole chart of mixing plant is automatic, and this arrow is showing that the flow, how it is flowing to each container and compartment. So these three items, pigments, oil and resins, they will flow to big tank which is attached here, that is known as feed tank. And in that feed tank, these three constituents will be supplied. And from that feed tank, weighing machine is there, that is called weighing tank. So it will come in a very big tank, that is weighing tank. And this weighing tank is attached to a ground floor, it is a big weighing platform. And that platform will give the weight of the whole mixture, because everything has to be calculated. And that, after this scaling, from here it will come here, and after taking the weight, then the whole mixture, that is batch material, will be transferred into another big container, that is called mixer. And in that mixer, in the previous I have already told you, there are sigma type of blade, and that is very effective blade, and that will rotate, and it will be thoroughly mixed. And after mixing, then it will come to your grinding mill. It is your grinding mill, and in this grinding mill it will be grinded. And there are different type of grinding machines are there: stone grinding, steel grinding. It depends upon what type of oil and what type of pigment you are using and what type of paint you are manufacturing. On that basis, you are going to use the grinding machine. And in that grinding mill, after the grinding, then the whole mixture, after fine grinding, it will go to the other tank, and that tank is known as tinting and thinning tank. So in that tinting and thinning tank, directly from here, tinting and thinner will be supplied here. So here all mixtures will be mixed together in this thinning and tinting tank. Tinting material is added just to give the strength to the paint, and thinning is a solvent. It can be naphtha, it can be spirit, it can be castor oil, in order to make it uniform so that very easily, smoothly it can be applied on any surface like wood surface or metal surface or anywhere. And after that is thoroughly mixing this in that thinning tank, then it will be transferred to, that is called very big tank, hopper. It will come to hopper, and coming after the hopper, then everything is checked here, quality checking. This is the final product which is reaching here, and then from here it will automatically will pass on to that is filling machine. So here nozzle type of filling machines are there. It depends at a time how many nozzles are there to fill 10, 20 or 1 dozen these type of containers. In this it will be filled, and once it is filled, then with that there is attachment of labeling machine. It will roll to that labeling machine and it will be labeled as per your industrial trademark. Once it is labeled, then it will be transferred to carbon packaging. Carbon packaging means now the packaging technique is also very sophisticated, and there are different techniques with air, without air, 2-layer, 3-layer packaging, carbon packaging, cellulose packaging, air dried packaging. So what type of requirement is there, according to that it is used in that packaging, carbon packaging center, and from there then it will be shifted on the belt for shipping. That is, it is going finally to your ship or your truck, wherever it is required. So finally, once the paint is manufactured, the main property of paint, that is called setting of the paint on the surface of the wood or metal where it is applied. So that is very important, because setting means how it is going to be coated, and it is durable, and it has strength, it can stick to it. And for that, two reactions are very important once it is applied, because it is the mixture of different constituents, pigment and unsaturated oil. So this unsaturated oil means it contains double bond. So two reactions will take place in presence of air. In air there is oxygen, so oxidation will take place and polymerization, and these reactions will allow the drying of the oil and setting of the paint on the surface where it is coated, whether it is metallic or wood. So here the setting of the paint, when paint is applied on the surface of the metal or wood, the oil present in it forms a protective film of dried oil. The film is formed through oxidation by air and polymerization of unsaturated constituents. So once, I have already told you that it is applied, two reactions are very important: polymerization, where lot of unsaturation will be polymerized, means in long chain formation will be there, so the small molecules will be polymers, and of the oxidation by air and polymerization of the unsaturated constituents of the drying oil. The dry present in the paint accelerates. I have already told you that we are adding dryers, and that dryer is responsible of catalyzing, accelerating the drying process, accelerates the drying of the protective film through oxidation and polymerization, and thus it will act as catalyst. The role of this agent, that is dryer, is as a catalyst for these reactions. The pigments strengthen the film and protect it by reflecting the destructive ultraviolet light. So it will also help to protect from negative effect or destructive ultraviolet alive while extenders increase the covering power and weathering power of the pigment. So covering power, and it will not be affected much by atmosphere or weather. That power will be increased, and that is a pigment, and thus improve the consistency and then leveling and setting. So these factors are responsible which will make the paint setting, leveling, and the cracking aspects are reduced by adding some oils which is known as plasticizer. I have already discussed the chemicals and the role of plasticizers that will not allow the paint to get cracked, means cracking, wrinkling will not take place once you use the plasticizer. In fact, continuous hard film is formed by the combination of pigment particles by the film of the oil. So, in selecting the paint, there are some requirements of good paint, and these requirements are given here. Number two, that is requirements of good paint, Roman one. Pigment should be opaque to ensure good covering power. Second, it should be chemically inert to susceptibility and hence long life. So I mean, it should be chemically inert so that it can secure the susceptibility and hence long life. Three, paint should have good color and high hiding power. Number four, it should be weather resistant of atmosphere and air. Number five, it should have good washability and metal anti-corrosive property. Number six, its consistency should be suitable to appreciation by the types of application such as brushing, dipping, spraying, coating. Number three, next point, the individual requirements are however met by proper choice of these things, like first pigments, extenders and drying oils. So the individual requirement, which is very important for proper selection of these ingredients, first is pigments with good color, with good quality, then extenders and drying oil. Drying oil also one of the medium of dispersion, it should be of good quality. According to modern point of view, various requirements such as gloss, washability, durability and reflectance are largely controlled by pigment volume concentration. This is the measurement here that is known as pigment volume concentration, and that is always mentioned by PVC. Here it is not polyvinyl chloride in plastic industry. Here PVC means pigment volume concentration. P stands for pigment, V stands for volume, and C stands for concentration, and which is given in the form of ratio is PVC is equal to volume of pigment in paint divided by volume of non-volatile oil in paint. And then the PVC range varies, paints are given. So the PVC range of various paints I have given here, and it should be within this range. When you are going to manufacture or you are going to purchase the paint, you have to see PVC value and range. So the first is, once you are manufacturing flat paint, its PVC range should be from 50% to 70%. Number two, semi-gloss paint, In the case of semi glass pane, the PVC range should be 35 to 45%. Number three, glass panes. In the glass panes, the PVC range should be 25 to 35%. Number four, exterior house paint. It should be 28 to 36%. Number five, metal primers. It should be 25 to 40%. Number six, wood primers. In the case of wood primers, it should be 35 to 40%. So you have to check in all these six panes the PVC ranges. If that range is not there, it means that paint is of bad quality, it is not good. And what is the importance of PVC? It has three importance. First, the gloss decreases as PVC increases. In this way, paint becomes flat. I mean, the quality will not be good once the PVC is increasing. Number two, with increase in PVC, adhesive as well as durability both decreases, and paint will be in powder form with less durability. So once there is increase in the PVC, the paint will be in powder form, it will not be durable. Number three, when extenders are added, the PVC increases. Once you are adding in the paint extenders, automatically PVC will increase and glass will be decreased. So with this I will stop. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.